I'm MaryBeth Carpenter. I'm Executive Director of Preservation Zebulon. We are delighted that we were just awarded a National Register Historic District in Zebulon. It encompasses 318 structures over almost 165 acres. This was awarded by the National Park Service on August 22nd. This was the end of a five-year process to try to get a district. In 2017, Preservation Zebulon was formed as a nonprofit out of a grassroots group of individuals who were interested in forming to get a historic district and try to preserve some of the structures in town. So my husband Scott and I bought this house 7 years ago. We were looking for a Queen Anne Victorian that we wanted to save, and we were looking for a community that was friendly, that we could see ourselves becoming established in. And we found this house and fell in love with it. Looking around, we saw a number of other homes in the neighborhood that we thought could maybe use a little bit of help. And so we thought, instead of just doing one house, that we would look to getting a whole district. And we had enough interest that we went ahead and formed Preservation Zebulon with the goal of getting one or more historic districts. When structures are torn down, it's more than just a building going into a landfill. The memories disappear. When a house stays up, the information about the builders of our town, or just people who had lived here, multiple families over the years, those go away. And we'd like to restore and preserve the memories of the people who made our town such a great place to live in and be. I'm standing in front of the William and Delaney Wiggs House. This home was built in 1912, and this fabulous Queen Anne home was once the home of a successful tobacco merchant. William Wiggs was also a Wake County commissioner, and he was also a commissioner of roads back in the 19-teens and 20s and 30s. In the back part of the house, there was a stable and a shed and lots of tales of plenty of gardens back here. This home was built in 1918 by E.C. Daniel, who owned Zebulon Drug Store. He also became Zebulon's mayor. E.C. and Elva raised their son E.C. Jr. here. He became the editor of the New York Times. He married Margaret Truman, who is the daughter of President Harry S. and Bess Truman. President Truman visited here twice and spent the night in 1958 and in 1960. This home is a Wake County Historic Landmark. It's in beautiful shape inside. It's a craftsman style home. And we're just delighted to have such a beautiful home with historic character in our neighborhood. This beautiful folk Victorian home was built by R.J. Whitley somewhere in the 1920s. R.J. Whitley had started Zebulon Supply Company, which then became Whitley Furniture Galleries about a block further on Arundel Avenue. When he died in 1924, he was worth over $1 million. This home has a lot of fanciful details and has gone through several hands and is being restored now by the current owner. R.J. Whitley also ran a bank in Zebulon and was a mayor. This home was built in 1950 by Clarence Strickland. He owned a contracting business along with his brothers. It was later owned by Lorenzo Temple, who ran Temple's Market for many, many years downtown. The house was converted to apartments and then was converted back again to single family use in 1989. It's a beautiful home inside with a lot of great Queen Anne detailing. It's a point of pride for the town to have this historic district, and we can't wait to get started on educating anyone who has a structure contributing to the district on how they can get tax credits.